Africa. Told myself to push and never stop. I've been stressed out, watching both these hands around the clock. With my eyes wide, trying to get the panorama shot. Whole world getting blurry to me, answers getting lost. So I watch my...
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know what you guys are thinking, that usually I show you guys how to put on makeup, but right now I'm just removing it. But yeah, that's kind of like my twist, you can say. And I know right now I'm looking horrible, but I think you guys will excuse me for that. So today for this video, I'm really excited, because right now a trend is going on all over internet, that is people, human beings are turning themselves into Bratz dolls. And I personally believe that's an amazing challenge. And I mean, I had to create this. How can I not create something this awesome, right? So here I am today. I'm going to show you how I created this look, and which right now I'm removing. So without further ado, let's jump right in.
So here I am with blocking my brows. I know I look horrible right now. And now I'm going to just apply the foundation. And for this look, we actually need full coverage, like as high coverage as you can get. And for this, I am using my Sugar Cosmetics Ace of Face foundation stick and mixing it with Maybelline Superstay foundation. Both of them are like known for their heavy coverage, and mixing them too will just give me a plastic like complexion today. That is very important, because for God's sake, we are turning ourselves into breasts. Also, the blocking of my eyebrow step I have skipped here, because to be very honest, nothing new I have done here. I will link a video where I have shown how I have blocked my brows. This is not like perfect, but I can just work with it. I'm not a pro, you guys, you know that. So for my concealer, I'm using my Wet n Wild Photo Finish Concealer. Again, this concealer is like really high coverage, and its consistency is pretty thick and just perfect for this look. So I'm just applying that in usual areas and just blending it with my sponge. I'm applying my concealer over my brows also, just to give them like more coverage. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to set my face like there is no tomorrow. And for that, I'm using my trusted baby powder. This one is from Johnson & Johnson, but to be very honest guys, you can use any baby powder. And this step is really important, because we have actually used like 100 layers of foundation already, so we don't want anything to crease, and that's why I'm just setting it. I have done one eye off camera already, don't you worry, I'm not going to skip anything. I am going to show you what I have done. So here what I'm doing is I'm just taking my trusted James Charles palette, and I'm dipping my brush into the controversial shadow called Skip, and I'm just applying it way over my actual crease, because we need that very draggish and very doll kind of accentuated eyes. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to dip my brush in the shade called Escape and Single. Basically, I'm just going to mix these two purple shade and going to just deepen that fake crease out a bit more. All the shadows are blending really nicely. I mean, you guys already know how James Charles palette works. I have done already a full review on that. So if you want, I will link it in the screen so that you can go and watch. Next, I am going to reapply that shadow Skip all the way up to my brow bone, because again, our eyes are like screaming on our face, so we just need to accentuate our eyes very dramatically. The bigger the better. And I'm just going in and re-intensify everything. And next, what I'm doing is I'm taking a large fluffy brush and just blending all the colors together, just to give it a smooth transition, that we are going to for a dramatic look, but we don't want a dramatic look to be unblended, to be very honest, right? And then I'm just dragging that same purple shadow in my lower lash line too. Next, I'm going to take this kind of purple shimmery shadow, and I'm going to apply it on my brow bone. As a reference picture, right now I'm looking at the Bratz doll has a very shimmery brow bone kind of area, so I'm just trying to mimic that. Then I'm going to cut my crease with this NYX eyeshadow primer. This is in the shade white, and the reason I'm taking a white eyeshadow primer because I need my eyelid to be very vivid and bright, almost kind of whitish. And I'm just cutting my crease with a flat tip brush, nothing fancy here. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to lay off those same pink and purple colors on the outer corner of my crease. And in the inner corner of my eyes, I'm going to pat this shade called Sister. It's a very light kind of peachy pinky tone, and it's obviously a shimmer shade, and this just goes perfectly for this kind of eye look. Now it's time for that larger than life winged eyeliner, and for that I'm just trying my level best to match my other eye, because that's the whole point, right? I mean, here my skill set is going to be tested, so just calm down, Priyanka. And for this step, I'm just using this NYX Feltip eyeliner. Basically, any eyeliner you can use which has a pretty small tip, because that way you will be able to control your eyeliner and you will be able to gradually build it up, and that will just going to decrease your chances to mess it up. Yeah. Once I'm done with my eyeliner, I'm just going to drag it all the way, not all the way, or like halfway through my lower lash line. And next I'm switching to another eyeliner. This one is from Sugar. I think this one is called I Want You So. This is a very nice matte black eyeliner. I use it on an everyday basis, and it has a very precise tip. This is just perfect to mimic that fake inner corner, and that's what I'm doing right here. Then I'm going to take this NYX shimmer eyeliner. This is basically a glitter eyeliner, and I'm not really sure about the shade, but don't worry guys, as I always do, I am going to list every single thing in my description box, so just do check them out. I'm just going to outline my crease part and the upper half of my liner, and because I don't know why I'm doing it, because my reference picture has a similar kind of effect, so I'm just going to mimic that. Now to tightline my lower lash line, I'm going to use this Sugar Kohl pencil, and I'm just tightlining my lower lash line halfway through, not the all the way back to the inner corner. And for my inner corner, I'm using this NYX Jumbo pencil in the shade called Milk, and just painting my fake inner corners too. I hope I'm making sense, it's not that confusing. So just keep watching, you will understand what I'm talking about. For my lower lash line, I'm going to mix Skip, Escape and Love That, and just going to smoke the hell out of it. To add some extra glitter, I am taking a silver glitter liner and just applying it on my brow bone. Now I'm going to draw my star, and for that I am actually taking a help of a ruler. I know it sounds just insane, but this is not the first time guys that I have use some geometrical instruments in my makeup. I mean, I have used a freaking compass to draw a perfect circle on my chest in my first ever NYX Face Awards India video. Just in case if you want to watch that, I will link in the screen. So here I'm just freehandedly drawing a star, and sometimes I'm just taking help of that geometric ruler. And once I'm done outlining the star, I'm going to shade it out, and for that I'm taking the same shade called Skip and applying it on the star with help of a flat tip brush. To give it a nice glow and that extra highlighting kind of effect, I am taking that same shade called Sister and just applying it with the same brush. And I'm applying the shadow right beside the pink shade as if that star is glowing. Now to add some more blink, I am taking these loose glitters and just sticking them on my brow bone area. We are almost done our eyes. Now it's time to add those fake lashes. These are actually double stack eyelashes which are custom made, not like really custom made. I actually made them to give that very nice doll eyelash. And for my lower lash line, I'm just going to draw those false lashes according to the reference picture that I'm referring to. And here I'm just like taking really close look to my reference picture. So if you guys are wondering that what I am doing, so yeah, I'm just looking at my reference picture, okay? Now it's time to bronze our face. That is really, really important. And I am here just applying a powder bronzer all over my face, like my jawbone, my pretty wide forehead and my nose. And for that I'm using the NYC bronzer. You can use any bronzer matched to your skin tone. Next, I have added blush and highlighter. I am so sorry guys that somehow my camera stopped recording that part. That part is really easy. And for the highlighter and for the blusher, what I have used is Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighter in the shade called Winter Falls in LA, and I have used the NYX Sweet Cheeks blush palette. It's time to do my lips, and for that you just need to draw, like overdraw your lips like there is no tomorrow, and exactly what I'm doing right here. You can see that I am outlining my lips way bigger what it actually looks like. And just take your time and try to perfect that lip shape. And once I'm done outlining my fake lips, I'm going to fill my lips with the NYX Cosmic Metal Lip Gloss in the shade called Speed of Light. Has a very nice shimmery color, which is perfect for this look. Yeah, that was it guys. I really enjoyed recreating this look. This brass doll is actually inspired by the Martin Cantor's brass doll. He is an amazing artist and he creates amazing brass doll. So if you like this video, then don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my channel. That will just mean world to me, and I will see you in my next video. Take care, bye.